All right, back with part two of Game Day, Week 9. Here we go. We're going to start off with the, we got the Owls taking on Mississippi Tech, Blue Raiders. We're also going to have Gulfport going to be taking on Northeast Alabama State. And we're having some technical difficulties. But we try to keep you up to date what's going on down there in the deeper part of Mississippi. So we in North Mississippi and we in the South of Mississippi. And as you can see, it's the West. All right, here we go. We're going to start off with a kickoff here by Central Tennessee. We're going to start off here trying to see which quarterback that is. That's Masterson. Yeah, he's starting it off for the Mississippi Tech. Got a nice little run. Whoa, got a nice run right here. That was Rick Rader. Rider. Why I keep calling him Rader for? Rider. Tell you what, Rider really taking over the running game since the injury to Red number one. He made sure to get the route at least to that. A lot of people thought that one of his brothers was gonna step up, but no, it's been Rider. Nice little throw right there to Sammy, and we're gonna keep and get a nice first down run there by Mass. Gain of 13, and nope, gave it that time. And Jimmy Reed, he got caught in the backfield. Hand it off here to Rider, and he's gonna take it in. And boom, the first scores of the game goes to the Blue Raiders. And here come Barker, and coming in with a nice throw right there in the first down. He's still running. Hey, look at him go. And they make the stop. Whoa. I said, who was that mass man? Then a nice little throw here. And just going to run people over for the touchdown. That was Snoop Bacon. Snoop Bacon. All right. Well, got a sack right here. That looked like Auburn right there. West Auburn. Okay, quarterback gonna drop back here. Nice little throw. Oh, incomplete. Couldn't get it in there. After a punt, Tennessee got Central Tennessee. Got a first down right there. Caught in the backfield right there. Nice defense right there. And forced the field goal. And it's good. And it is now 10-7. And they get nice yardage on that run. Got a nice run right there. And after a punt, got a nice throw right there. No. Incomplete. Got it knocked down. Running an option right here, but the pitch man got taken out. So the quarterback didn't have a choice but to run it. And there you go, 10-7, end of the first quarter. Now we're going to take a little sneak peek down in what's going on in Gulfport, as they have a 10-0 lead in the first quarter, at end of the first quarter. Oh, the Rangers are not looking good down there. All right, going into the second quarter. Bo Jefferson with a catch. I think that's his second catch of the game. It might be his first, I don't know. And another catch by Jefferson. And the kick to field goal is good. 13-7. This is how the Owls build a lead. They don't mind kicking field goals, man. They'll kick field goals all day long. Quarterback drops back. Not much yards there by Rider. A Mike drops back, he's gonna hand off, caught in the backfield, right up for a loss of three. And at the punt, he's darker. He gets a yard on the run. Then he drops back looking, throws out here, incomplete. At the punt. He got him throw right there, another incomplete. That was the danger with the throw right there. And we got a completion. Few in between, huh? Got a nice little dump off right here. And nice run by Gamble after the catch. And then he's just going to hand it off. Oh, he got the first down, though. Billy Ray Hayes got the first down. Wasn't able to get it, punch it in, but Gamble comes in and punches it in. Boom. And it's 19-7. Ow. With a halftime lead of 20-7, is starting to run away with this one. They got to get back in the game. All right. Let's see how the second quarter fared for down at Gulfport. Well, the Rangers finally got on the board, and they went for two, and it's 10-8. Then, just before the end of the half, they was able to score another touchdown and make it 16-10. So, hey, you got a nice game going right now down there in Gulfport. Third quarter action. Oh, he get punched in the mouth by Gamble on the five-yard reception. Later on the drive. Nice catch out there. Had all kinds of space. Got a flag though. Later on in the drive, and boom, Barker is in for the score. And it is now 26-7. And after they did absolutely nothing but three downs and out, Barker and company got the ball back, but he throws an interception. Interception. So, Blue Raiders got the ball. And a handoff right here. Nice little run. Some extra yards right there. Down 27-14. Late in the third quarter. And they're doing their best trying to make a game of it. Nice catch. Lost yard. Rust. Hand off. Hey, breaking a tackle there. So Jimmy Red for about 5 yards. Then the handoff here. Whoa, Jimmy Red again, 4 yards. Okay, he is trying to make up where his brother left off. Brother was injured early in the season. That's a run by Danger right there. Whoa! Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback decapitation. Nah, man. Got a fake right there. Nice little run right here. Ooh. And Danger is running the ball well lately. He's supposed to be the passer. All right, the end of the third, 27-14. Going into the final stanza, as they used to say. We're checking out how the third quarter went down in the Gulfport, as the Warhawks was able to take the lead 17-16. And then later on, it was able to add a field goal to make it 20-16. And like I said, we got a good one down there in the southern part of Mississippi. Back up here up north. Hey, somebody, Danger. They trying to make it a good game here, as they was able to score a touchdown on that run, get the extra point. It's now 27-21. And now the defense is starting to wake it up. Who would that? I said Spencer Yale on the sack. So, hey, they needed that. All right, back with the ball again. Mississippi Tech. And Alabama slam with the catch. First time we called his name in this game. Whoa, they got an interception right here. He almost took it back. Whoa. That came at a horrible time. Simply horrible. Big play for the Owls. Just when it looked like Mississippi Tech had a chance of taking the lead, or at least tying it up. But Snoop Bacon catches this one and makes it 33-21. The bacon is frying today, baby. And Matthew Knight with the catch on the two-point conversion is now 35-21. Woo! And boom, dangerous cut in the backfield. After a punt, a turnover on downs. And there's a nice run right there by Barker. Gain of 5. And then Matthew Knight with the touchdown right here. Got the Owl jumping, baby. Let's see how it unfolded, though. Nice little throw, and he just outruns his man. Just couldn't catch up. Nice play, Matthew Knight. The big playmaker. And that was Danger got caught. Danger is playing a lot in this game. Got a throw right here. Almost another interception. Kelly Key. You got to catch that, man. Danger still playing. And the toss here. Oh, what a catch by Wayne. Mark Wayne with the catch. And the touchdown. You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offense. And it's now 42-28. And it carries the ball for a nice game. Gamble with the 7-yard run right there. Boom, got a nice run right there by Gamble. Gain of 8. Mississippi Tech taking their timeouts. Got a run right here. Oh, and another first down. And that'll do it, man. That will do it by Gamble and Company. What a big win for the Owls. Player of the game right here, Snoop Bacon. And he just run people over, and he said, "You will not stop me from scoring." And it's a big win for the Central Tennessee, as they are now looking like the best team in the conference. Disappointing loss. Mississippi Tech, they just had just a terrible, horrible season. And they had such high expectations coming in. All right, we're going to see what happened down at Gulfport. And as you can see, 27-16 is the final score, as the Warhawks was able to pull off the win. And, wow. All right, now we're going down to Mississippi A&T. Down in Jacksonville, where they play. And they're taking on Louisiana A&M. And as you can see early in the game, all about some defense. But then, got a nice little run right here for a score. Touchdown by Cross. Oh! Good jump. Protection and a well-placed ball. Most times trying to work their way back into the game here is the Cottonmouth. There. As they is able to get a field goal. And they started to play a little defense here. That had to wait. And in the first quarter, 7-3. And then, whoa, the Sailfish get some defense. As Florida was able to get the interception by Corey Hoffer. And a pick six, another pick six this week. We done had so many pick sixes in the last couple of weeks, especially this week. This was pick six, like heaven or something. And another interception. Whoa. And we had to miss that tackle. That would have been another pick six.
I think he's forcing the issue out there.
Thornton is not having a game. Thornton is not having a game that you like to have. And now they'll go cross, and he's in again. Touchdown. Selfie. And all of a sudden, it's 20-3. And they are not playing. Oh. And the Cottonmouths is getting moited.
Brad, to see this offense maybe go back to this play a little bit later in the game for me.
Now, unfortunately, this is basically all the video that we have on this game. The rest of the video just wasn't up to snuff. Just completely corrupted. So we just gonna go on and flash the score of the game. Ended up being a 38-13 win for the Sailfish. And basically we just gonna wrap up part two of week nine game day. And we're gonna push forward, baby. So, hey, to the next episode, you have a good one.